with us here on this busy Wednesday afternoon here on the Great Sirius XM 82. A spirited program today as we chat on the Great Sirius with our good buddies Eddie Erickson and Colin Smelling, yours truly, Christopher Russo. As we take you home, you heard Keith Jones here on a Game 7 tonight, NBC, of course. They are sports, one of their analysts with the pregame and postgame on Capitals. We'll do that in a sec as we take you home here in your last hour together on this weekday program. We'll start with the headline of the day, and it's not going to be the NFL with the whole situation with the kneel down. That's not sports. I'm not interested in social issues today. Not when I have too many good sports going on here in late May. What I'm interested in is the Rockets and the Warriors and the Cavaliers and the Celtics. Last night, what was really a complete gut check by a Houston team that, quite honestly, I don't think a lot of us thought had it in them, whether that be down 12-0 early, 2-1 in the series that had resumed in Golden State after the blowout in Game 3, or down 82-70 after the Rockets had a 7-point lead at halftime. For that team to come off the deck, play excellent defense, get right in the faces and the grills of the Golden State big stars and Durant and Curry and Thompson, and to score just enough. They were not great offensively either. Scored just enough in the fourth quarter and to claw their way back in the game and to play a championship gutty, gritty ball game as they did to get back in this conference final with Golden State was really impressive. And quite honestly, I don't think any of us thought that they had it in them. I know I didn't think they had it in them. I wasn't sure about a D'Antoni kind of team, if they had that intestinal fortitude. He's an offensive coach. His teams have never shown that guts in a big, whether they can stop anybody with a real gut check from a defensive perspective. Harden's not a great defensive player. He's horrendous. He anticipates fairly well, but he's a horrendous defensive player. But not the case yesterday. They were gritty, gutty, feisty, did what they had to do. I mean, that team only scored 12 points, the Warriors, in the fourth quarter. Curry, after a tremendous flurry in the third quarter, which got the Warriors turned around, did nothing late. Durant was passive, did nothing late. Klay Thompson was more wrapped up on an injury than he was about playing basketball. Draymond Green, this is where he gets himself in a little trouble because he can't score. He missed a free throw. He can't shoot, missed big threes, missed a dunk. And this is where he gets hurt there. Iguodala had nothing to do with this. They lost this game because of their offense, not because of their defense. They only allowed Houston to score 95 points. I mean, it's not like Houston scored 130. So this is not what Chris Webber, who had a rough game. And in this kind of setting, Webber's just not a big-time analyst. Reggie is. Miller does a good job. He's very solid. I used to get out of Miller. I can't do that anymore. He's a good analyst. He's a good analyst. He's got nice, easy delivery. Does a good job. Weber's terrible. And he tries to speak in 18-second sound bites. He doesn't make a ton of sense. He's just not very good. So as a result, defense and rotations, and that was not the story of the game. The story of the game is the Houston defense in the fourth quarter prevented Golden State from getting anything accomplished and established with their primary weapons from an offensive standpoint. We all know Golden State's got a ton of offensive weapons. We all know that you have to normally outscore them to beat them. Well, yesterday what occurred is that Houston outdefensed them, which is very rare with Golden State to win a game like that against them where you outdefense them. Normally, you got to outscore them. If you're going to win that kind of game on the road yesterday, it's going to be 135-131. Well, they won a game 95-92, which I didn't think it was possible at the Oracle to prevent that team from not scoring a ton of points. And that's what Houston did yesterday, so we give Houston all the credit in the world. And they have really reestablished a lot of life as far as this conference final goes because, it would not stun me right now, and it certainly would have before the series. It would have stunned me after game two. It's going to stun me after game four or after game three. It would have stunned me after game one and game three. It would have stunned me before the series, and now it won't. And that's the idea that Houston can get to a final. I would not be floored if they won this series right now. They looked a little beleaguered last night, the Warriors. They look a little tired. They are a little banged up. They have a tendency to fart around in the game, get a little arrogant with the ball, especially. Their turnovers are a disaster. They're cocky turnovers. You know, they're lazy turnovers, which really bother you. And you know, you could tell Kerr drives him nuts when this occurs. And from that perspective, I mean, I think this team is, you know, somewhat vulnerable here from here on out. The one thing I think that I feel pretty confident about is I think if Houston does win a series, it's going to have to be in a seventh game. I do not think that Houston's going to win another game in Golden State. That's the one thing I would say, is that I think there's a much, much better chance that Golden State wins this series in six games than Houston winning this series in six games. So from that perspective, I do think that the best Houston can hope for is to win a seventh game on Monday night. But I think that right now is possible. I mean, they got two games at home. That's a great crowd. They've won championships, that crowd. They know how to support the team. Houston's got a good role going on right now with the Astros. Everybody's working now. We got this Santa Fe thing with the shooting. That, I think, even Paul mentioned that in the post game last night. I'd be a little worried if I was a Warrior fan right now. You can't just shrug this off. They're okay. They were due to lose a home playoff game. Okay. They kind of struggled offensively in the fourth quarter. Normally that won't occur again. Probably get Iguodala back here not too long if you make a big deal about that. So, you know, the Warrior fan that wants to shrug this aside being no big deal, that's a fan who's won too much, because you can always lose. And a Warrior fan right now that, you know, what's the big deal with 2-2? We're the Warriors. We have this guy. We have that guy. We have Curry. We have Durant. We win all the time. We were due to lose a game. Played lousy yesterday. Didn't have our, we weren't whole physically. That's a fan that doesn't respect losing, who thinks that, because they can lose this series now. I did not think they could, again, throughout this series, and I didn't think they could before it. I thought that Golden State would win no worse than six games, maybe quite possibly in five. Obviously, they can't win in five now, and they still could win in six, and all things would be forgiven if they did. But right now, it would not stun me in the least if Houston got to an NBA final. It really wouldn't. You can make an argument yesterday that what Houston did is they knocked a little arrogance out of the Warriors. They knocked a little soul out of the Warriors. That they stared the big bully down, and the other guy blinked first. And sometimes when you do that, that has a lasting effect. And let's also be fair, the Warriors, despite their two championships, even Durant, when they get in nutcracker times in the postseason, they have had a history, Durant, Curry, even Kerr, of coming up a little short. 3-1 lead, Cavaliers fell apart. Durant, 3-1 lead against Golden State, fell apart. Durant, big advantages earlier on against the Spurs. And, of course, against Miami, he was right there. Didn't get the job done. Last year, they were overwhelming with talent. They buried Cleveland. Durant was phenomenal. Nobody's going to argue that. So is Curry. But this is a different scenario now. This is a real, you know, last year everything went nice and easy. This is about toughness. And I wonder, I really do, I wonder what's deep in the Warrior soul. I don't trust Curry. He's not been great in the postseason. Outplayed by Kyrie Irving. He did not play. You know, he had a great flurry, but he didn't play well in the game. And Durant, I sometimes wonder about him too. And I've never been a Harden fan. And Paul. Maybe I believe in him now. That is story number one on a busy afternoon. Story number two will follow here on Mad Dog Unleashed.
You've heard from the doggy.